This week, the United States Marines invaded Boston Common to show off high-tech military hardware. While crowds were noticeably impressed with the heavy machines, such as the Osprey helicopter and the Abrams tank, the most cutting-edge military equipment came in much smaller packages. The Marine Forces System Command is a branch dedicated to integrating new technology into the Marines' inventory. Consumer electronics actually play a very big role in the Marines' technological arsenal.
So we have the toughbook, we have the ruggedized, and the semi-ruggedized. The ruggedized is the one that can take the most beating because they can drop, pick it up, like I said, and go on it. We have a great warranty program which provides the Marine the capability to remove and replace, repair their own equipment out in the field. So the toughbook is the best one.
Besides Panasonic toughbooks, imaging equipment is pulled off the shelf. Here, a thermal scope that can be mounted to a rifle or handheld is connected to a Sony video deck. Despite the target's hand leaving the table's surface, a thermal image is left behind that can be seen for up to several minutes. Using the heat signature, Marine investigators can tell what tasks were being performed a few minutes earlier. The Marines also use night vision lenses that attach to standard SLR cameras and transmit wireless data.
We also have over here are some camera systems that are part of the MSID system, which stands for the MAGTAF Secondary Imagery Dissemination System. It consists of a bunch of cameras and radios that allow special operations users to take pictures out when they're out on a mission and send that back to the command post so that we can analyze those photos for intelligence.
Xbox 360 controllers have found their way onto the battlefield as well to help control the Mini EOD, also known as the Devil Pup. The Devil Pup is a robot that helps to locate and dispose of explosives. Vision is provided to a special pair of goggles, allowing the operator to see what the Devil Pup sees. Developed in conjunction with iRobot, the same company responsible for the Roomba vacuum robot, the Mini EOD is lightweight and portable.
What you'll see on the robot, what we're trying to do is provide standoff from the Marine or soldier from an explosive device. And so what you'll see, it's got a manipulator. The two of the robots have manipulator arms and cameras, both low light, infrared cameras and visual cameras. And they go out and provide standoff from devices.
Its bigger brother, the Talon, is controlled more traditionally with a laptop and joysticks. It is also designed to neutralize explosive devices, keeping soldiers at a safe distance. Another technology to keep soldiers safe is the SLD-500 surveillance system, a device that detects snipers.
What you have is a laser, and it'll shoot out about a mile to a mile and a half, and it's a sniper detection system. So it detects the optical glint off of a scope, and then shoots it back into, you've got your Panasonic toughbook. We don't have the alarm set up, but it has an alarm. It'll send the signal back to the user, and the user can evaluate whether or not it is in fact, a sniper out there, or it's just some other sort of data.
To detect larger scale threats such as rockets, the Marines use counter-battery radar. The system detects ordnance fired in real time and relays that information so that people can be alerted to the threat and countermeasures can be taken.
Before the enemy mortar rounds even land, there has been times where we have artillery already on its way. So while that enemy is waiting to see where their rounds go, we already have friendly artillery going on top of that enemy and taking care of that threat.
Even Apple's iPod is making it into the Marines' technological toolkit. Using developer kit iPod touches, the Marines have created a pocket reference application, including local customs and sayings, videos showing pronunciation, and equipment schematics. They were quick to point out that none of the information on the iPod is classified, so there's no real threat if it's lost. Reporting from Boston, I'm Justin Meisinger, IDG News Service.